had the dream, they couldn't understand. They began to draw on what they had learned, but it wasn't enough. And the king said, if you can't tell me the dream, and if you cannot give me an interpretation, you will die. And he wasn't just talking to one, he was talking to all, including Daniel. And the king's commander went out to carry the execution. And Daniel said to him, wait a minute. What's going on here? Give me some time. Let me just talk to the king for a moment. I know a God who is able. I have a connection with someone who can. Give me a little time.
Every time of anniversary, there's always a release of gifts.
The Lord said, this is what I'm supposed to do. Therefore, Lord, turn it around to conform to your will. Turn it around to conform to your purpose for me.
So we want to thank the Holy Spirit, who is already with us.
After he interpreted it, what happened? He was elevated divinely. Now, why did God promote him? Why did God elevate him? Because Joseph decided to run away from sin, run away from compromise, run away from so many things that would defile you, run away from lies, run away from deceit, run away from hypocrisy, run away from anger, bitterness, run away from unforgiveness. And that is what God said to do, what? Yes. To divinely elevate you.
If my Jesus is no longer in the grave, no man can kill you. If my Jesus was never poor, then I cannot be poor. If my Jesus was not limited, I cannot be limited. You must be able to see your life through the spectacle of Christ. But I believe God this evening that you will come to a full understanding of who your God is. Rather, I believe that you will come into that spirit of wisdom and revelation in the intimate cognitive of the knowledge of Christ. Become so revealed unto you that it becomes your lifestyle in the name of Jesus.
I have this good news for you here. After this anniversary, your head shall be lifted up.
Amen.
Your story will definitely change. Amen. No matter what has been there before today,